In this video, I am going to explain basic bony landmark of knee joint. And in second part, I am going to explain basic connective tissue around knee joint, okay? So you are looking left side knee joint from front view. This is left side knee. So the first thing is this one, this is patella. Patella is on the knee joint. Then this is femur. This is tibia, and this is fibula. You know, fibula is not actually the part of knee joint, but this is very important bone as well. So the first bony landmark is this one, this big chunk on the femur. You know, this is lateral side. So this name is lateral condyle. And this big chunk is medial condyle. Lateral condyle and medial condyle. And you see this bony bump here, this tiny bony bump. This is lateral epicondyle. Epicondyle. This is the condyle. This is epicondyle. You know, epi means above or up or outside. So this is lateral epicondyle. And this is medial epicondyle, right? The condyle is bigger one, the epicondyle is smaller one. So, and this is tibia, and there's a condyle in tibia as well. This is lateral side, so this is lateral tibial condyle. This is lateral condyle of tibia, and this is medial condyle of tibia. And there's very big bony bump here. This is tibial tuberosity. Tibial tuberosity. If somebody has big tibial tuberosity, that can be Osgood-Schrader. You have heard this, right? Tibial tuberosity. Lateral tibial condyle and medial tibial condyle. And tibia has the flat surface inside. And this is tibial plateau. Plateau means the flat surface, okay? And let's go to the fibula a little bit. This is fibula. This is very long bone. This is head of fibula. As I said, fibula is not technically a part of knee joint, but this is important. Why? Because the hamstrings attach on fibula. You know, hamstring is very important for knee flexion, so fibula is also important. So that's the basic bony landmark you should remember. This is patella. This is lateral condyle. This part is lateral epicondyle. This part is medial condyle, medial epicondyle. Then lateral condyle of tibia, the medial condyle of tibia, tibial plateau inside, tibial tuberosity, head of fibula. Okay, so in next part, I am going to explain basic connective tissue around knee joint. Now this is closer view and you see a lot of connective tissue. This is right side knee joint. You're looking from front side. That's opposite from the first part, okay? This is right side of knee joint. The first connective tissue is this one. This connects patella and tibial tuberosity. This part is patella tendon. Patella tendon is actually a continuation from quadriceps. Okay? So this is very, very important structure, patella tendon. Okay? Then, before I jump into the ligaments around knee joint, let me explain this light blue color. This is meniscus. Meniscus. And this is medial side. That's why this is medial meniscus. Medial meniscus. And this is the lateral side. That's why this is lateral meniscus. Okay? Medial meniscus, lateral meniscus. Let's go to the medial side of the knee joint. This ligament is very wide and very thick. This is medial collateral ligament, very famous ligament, also known as MCL. Medial collateral ligament, MCL. MCL and medial meniscus has strong relationship. Many times when people got injury on medial meniscus, oftentimes MCL is also affected. Many times, okay? So let's go to lateral side. This lateral side is the smaller and thinner than MCL. Let's compare. See, much different. MCL and this ligament. This ligament is lateral collateral ligament, LCL, lateral collateral ligament. Again, let's compare with MCL. MCL, very wide, thick. LCL, not much. Okay, so MCL and LCL are on the side of the knee joint. There are two more very famous ligaments in knee joint. You don't see that in model, but here, very deep inside. Actually, there are two famous ligaments. That's ACL, anterior cruciate ligament, and PCL, posterior cruciate ligament. Let me arrange the knee joint. Now you are looking the knee joint from above and front part. This is tibia, this is femur, patella, and this is right side of the knee joint. This is lateral side, this is medial side. So I use right finger closes and put on the knee joint. What does this mean? Right side knee joint, right fingers. My middle finger represents orientation of ACL. So ACL runs like this, lateral up to the medial inferior. Okay, this crossing fingers. My middle finger is ACL. My index finger is PCL. So there's a cross, right? That's why it's anterior or posterior cruciate ligament. Okay, again, right side of the knee. I use right hand, cross my fingers, then put on the knee joint. My middle finger is ACL and my index finger is PCL. This is very easy and good to remember orientation of these two ligaments. Okay, so four ligaments so far. MCL, medial collateral ligament, LCL, lateral collateral ligament, then I flip it. This is right side knee. I use my right hand finger. My middle finger is ACL. My index finger represents PCL. This orientation is very, very important. So in this video, in first part, I explained basic bony anatomy around knee joint. And in second part, I explained you the basic anatomy of connective tissue on knee joint. I hope this video helps your understanding of anatomy. If you liked today's video, please like, comment, and subscribe. See you in next video.